my boss has had a look at you. I can assure you that it will be dangerous, and that you'll be paid fairly.
I don't mind danger, so long as I get paid well enough.
You'll get paid the starting rate, like everybody else. If you turn out to be as useful as you claim, then we can talk about a raise. By the way, I'm Edward Deegan. You'll mostly be working for me, but you'll need to talk to my boss first. His name is Jack Cabot. He likes to personally interview everyone I hire. He's careful like that. Come down to Cabot House in Beacon Hill and ask to talk to Jack. I'll let him know you're coming.
I'll meet you in the morning. You can show me what you got. If you're feeling lucky tonight, Diamond City, yeah, it's my thing. I flash my style.
Need a place to stay? Show try Hotel Rexford.
I do the boys a favor with all my manual
labor. Better keep your iron strapped on. Friendly advice.
Friendliest vault in all the Commonwealth. Because here, they don't shoot on sight.
You make the call.
Is that your Pip-Boy? It better be.
Thank you. your pit boy ever act up on you? Mine's been glitchy lately.
I heard one of the kids got bit by some sort of mutant rat.
Hope that pit boy belongs to you.
Heads up.
If I got it.
Welcome back. Nice to see the Commonwealth hasn't got you yet.
I don't know about you, but I can't stand to see any of those young'uns sick.
Hi, Calvin.
Sorry, new guy. Not a lot of time to talk right now.
I'll be quick, I promise.
Ha! We'll see about that. What can I do you for?
What do you do here?
Me? I'm just the lucky sucker in charge of maintenance here. Sorry if you heard me bickering with the Overseer earlier. She and I don't always see eye to eye.
So, there's a lot of upkeep going on right now.
Hell, you could say that again. Old Lady One here, she's a straight-up wreck. Pretty solid for a while, easy enough to keep up with her needs, but in the last few years or so, damn, she got feisty. Been going through tools like they were going out of style, so if you got any, I'd be more than happy to take them off your hands.
Sure, you got yourself a deal.
Stupendous. One less thing to bug the Overseer about. Anyway, here I am running my mouth when there's work to do. Sorry I can't talk longer, stranger.
Hey, Calvin.
Hey there, you got some tools for me today?
Yeah, here you go.
Perfect. Keep an eye out. We can always use more.
Austin got himself bit by a mole rat. So now they got us cooped up in here to watch Aaron.
Ashes!
It's ridiculous.
You found him! Thanks, mister. I was so worried about him.
You're welcome.
I'm so glad he's safe. Ashes! Bad kitty. I was so worried about you.
I hope you don't have anything that needs fixing. I really don't feel like working.
I know I don't like it either. But I'm just happy you're back.
She's looking pretty bad in there.
We keep the vaults.
Do something, Jacob.
I'm running the test as fast as I can, Priscilla. I can't treat Austin until I know what he's infected with.
Dr. Forsythe.
Not now, Bob. And you, stranger, will have to wait your turn. We have an emergency here. Austin got bitten by a mole rat. Isn't that enough, Jacob? There can't be that many mole rat diseases or toxins.
Rachel is examining the mole rat. Hopefully she'll find something. But these aren't ordinary mole rats. Who knows what kind of diseases they are carrying? Because he's just a child, it's affecting him more severely.
Dr. Forsythe, please. I think I found something that might help Austin.
Bobby!
Hold on, Priscilla. What is it, Bobby?
Well, you know that door Austin found? He found it because of me. I keep my private things in there. He saw me get them.
You mean your chems?
Get to the point, Bobby. What did you find in that place?
It's like a whole extra vault in there, but half ruined and caved in. There was this terminal there. So I started poking around in it. There were some notes and stuff about using mole rats to grow viruses. But they also said that they used them to make vaccines and treatments.
A secret vault. Good Lord, I've never heard of such a thing.
Bobby, you're a genius. A junkie genius. There might be a cure for whatever Austin got from that mole rat somewhere in that place. You there, how would you like to do Vault 81 a favor and possibly save my boy's life?
I'll do it. For Austin.
You have a good heart. Bobby here will show you where he keeps his secret stash. There is a chance that somewhere in there is a cure for Austin. If you find it, bring it to Dr. Forsythe. And for Austin's sake, please hurry.
Follow me.
Not that cure. Austin will certainly know.
What's taking so long?
Alive.
Think you can unlock that terminal?
Good plan. Don't know why they bothered encrypting it at all. Sure, that was gonna do it. There we go.
Duty. enforcement robot is a felony.
Alive.
Hell aroma is that. There's something. How are we doing on the hunt for Eddie's tapes?
Still searching for them.
Just let me know.
Go check that out.
I think that's out of reach.
Hey.
I'm listening.
Check it out.
I don't think I can get there.
Over here.
Plan.
Heads up.
Go on.
Take a look.
Can't get to it.
Another stranger. Are you Voltech Security? I've waited so very patiently for you to arrive.
Who the heck are you?
I am a Contagion's Vulnerability Robotic Infirmary Engineer, or CVRIE. The human scientists call me Curie. Or more properly, they called me this when they were alive. I repeat, are you Voltech Security?
These mole rats carry a disease. Do you know anything about it?
My poor little darlings. They were used to grow all manner of new and interesting pathogens. Then Vault citizens would be exposed to these viruses in the hopes that they would develop new antibodies. But they never got a chance to execute their plan. Clyde got out of his cage. He was smarter than the others. My sweet Clyde. He let out the others, and those poor scientists never stood a chance. Clyde's been dead for almost 2 centuries now, but his descendants have free run of the vault. I'm rambling. Where are my manners? Are you Voltech Security?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Superb! I placed an emergency call so long ago. I was beginning to think something dreadful must have happened. I am pleased to report I completed my primary duties 83 years ago. Thousands of pathogens were grown in the mole rat hosts. Then a single broad spectrum cure was developed to treat them all. Very satisfying work for many decades. Now, please tell me you are authorized to release me from the lab.
Why can't you just leave?
I require verbal or written authorization. Actually, any Vault-Tec employee, even you, could authorize me. You must be Vault-Tec, or you couldn't possibly be here.
These mole rats were lab rats?
Why, yes. I've grown quite fond of them over the years. But they outlived their usefulness 83 years ago.
I am so authorized. You are released.
Superb. I had almost given up all hope of living here. I'll open the door for you. Since you are a Vault-Tec representative, I entrust you with the broad spectrum cure I developed. If you have an equivalent to my digital Hippocratic Oath, please use it quickly to prevent any undue suffering. However, be advised, there is only one dose left, and I can no longer make any more. If that is all, I am most eager to leave.
You only have one dose?
That is correct. There used to be more, but they all expired. Sadly, the organic compounds necessary to make more have all deteriorated.
You're just giving me the cure?
My primary responsibility is to obey the orders of specified Vault personnel, even if those orders violate my ethical matrix. But since you have graciously discharged me of this duty, I can give you the cure without directly disobeying my previous order. And if you happen to use the cure to save a life, then this is just a happy coincidence, no? Hopefully now I can properly further my scientific research. Since my job here is done, I think I will follow you out.
Perfect.
I've never seen a synth before. It's kind of creepy.
If you need a doctor, Forsythe and Rachel are down in the medical.
It is stimulating traveling with you.
We keep the vault safe.
The cure. You found it.
How is Austin doing?
Do you think he'll survive the cure?
He's been unconscious since shortly after you left.
Here, take the cure and use it on the boy.
Only one dose? I hope this works. If it doesn't, there won't be anything to analyze to try again.
Let's hope this works.
I heard you had returned.
It shouldn't be long. Visitor from the Commonwealth saved your life.
Really? Gee, thanks, mister.
I was worried to death about you, Austin. What got into your fool head? Going into a place like that.
Nothing exciting ever happens here. I just wanted to see what was in there.
Well, if it hadn't been for our friend here, you might have died. Thank you. I know you made sacrifices to help him. I know Dr. Pinsky will be grateful. For my part, I'd like to give you the syringe. I had it for years and never really had a use for it.
She's not the only one. The whole vault is thankful. I'd like to give you a room here in the vault. A place you can call your own. It's in the main hall, on the left as you get off the elevator. Once again, thank you. I hope you enjoy your accommodation. I wanted to say thank you again for what you did for Austin. You've opened a lot of eyes around here, including my own. I had no idea of the dangers Vault Tech had hidden away so close to home. I can't believe so many died just behind our walls.
What do you know about Vault Tech?
I'm afraid not much. I've spent my entire life being thankful for the Vault, for the walls that protected us over two centuries. But not once have I had contact with them.
Whatever Vault Tech had planned, it failed. And took their entire staff out with it.
No arguments here. I hate to think of what they had planned for us. But on the good side, you made a real impression on our anti-Commonwealth people. They're realizing outsiders really can be trusted, and do more good than just providing resources. You'll always be welcome here. And I hope you make a habit of visiting. Having a trusted outsider would help serve as a reminder that the Commonwealth isn't something to fear and avoid.
Overseer.
The people here will never forget what you did for Austin.
Heads up.
I'm all ears.
Wait there.
I'll stay put. Here's what I've got.
Look alive.
What's the plan?
A moment, please. I have been trapped so many years. I believe it's customary to thank you for your role in saving me. My entire life has been in this vault. I have analyzed and learned everything there is to know here. So now I must see the rest of the Commonwealth, consult with scientists, unearth more data to challenge my hypothesis.
What are you looking to learn up there?
Down here is an enclosed system, and without the introduction of new mutagens, viruses, or bacteria, it is quite dull, medically speaking. The world up there is infinitely more complex. Who knows what diseases can be found and studied?
After the bombs, the Commonwealth is a little lacking in the science department.
But surely there is still men of learning out there, and if nothing else, there is data. I can see you already have company. I do not wish to intrude, but I must ask. Please, monsieur, can you take me with you?
It's no picnic up there. Anything you can do to help us survive?
But of course! I have been equipped with medical equipment. If you become injured in our journeys, I can administer steam packs. I also have defensive capabilities, a laser. But surely there's little reason to use that.
Come along then.
Excellent. We must embark at once.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road again? Get back to the hunt for Eddie Winter?
Not now.
Well, I'll be around if you change your mind.
Look alive.
Do you need something from me?
Nick.
Time to hit the road again? Get back to the hunt for Eddie Winter?
Not now.
Well, I'll be around if you change your mind.
You need something, yes?
Hey.
What is it?
Probably about time we parted ways.
I look forward to it.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road again? Get back to the hunt for Eddie Winter?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Whitaker thinks the work will start easing up now that he knows about those mole rats.
Need to check the water pumps again.
Looking for something? I have more stuff than I know what to do with.
I might be interested in buying or selling.
Great. I have all...
Still can't believe they found an entire new section of the vault.
Remember, no funny business.
Just the person I wanted to see. I wanted to thank you for what you did for Austin.
How is he doing?
He's recovering well, back to his normal self again. It's as if he doesn't even know what happened. It was a selfless act, something we don't see much of from the Commonwealth. You're a rare breed, the kind we could use more of both inside and out of Vault 81. Anyway, I'm sure you have plenty of things to get back to. I just had to say thank you for saving Austin. I may have my life's work, but that boy is what really keeps me going. Hybridization. It's got to be a flaw in the hybridization.
Hey,
there's something you need?
I'm sure you know all too well. I haven't always been the best at this job. Hey, let's face it. I've been pretty terrible. Thanks to the efforts of a few of my friends, I've decided to change how I look at things, how I live my life. I'd like to just take this opportunity to thank the Vault Dweller for lending me a hand. I really do appreciate it. All right, folks, that's enough sentiment from me. Let's get it on back to the music, shall we? Just try not catching me along with this one. I dare you. It's Uranium Rock by Warren Smith.
Aaron Someday told me how you saved Austin's life. I guess you're not bad for an outsider.
Hey, hold.
If you need something, ask Alexis. I can't make heads or tails of her story.
Hi.
Anything I can get you today?
I'll think about it.
Browse all you want. No rush.
Grant says I'm a bottomless pit when it comes to food.
Looking for something? I have more stuff than I know what to do with.
Let's see what you got.
Great.
If you need something, ask Alexis. I can't make heads or tails of this sort.
Too many folks these days count on violence to solve their problems. You only have to look around to see where that goes.
Anything I can get you today?
Let's see what you got.
Great. I have all sorts of odds and ends.
Nice, Pip-Boy. If it ever starts acting up on you, see Alexis. She'll fix it right up.
Excuse me.
Looking for something? I have more stuff than I know what to do with.
I'll think about it.
Browse all you want. No rush.
Hope you don't have anything that needs to fix. Excited about
now, watch this.
Hey.
I'm listening.
Head over there.
Count on it.
Heads up.
Go ahead. Take a look. Must have cost a fortune to build a place like this.
Message to Johnny Montrano. Johnny, Johnny, Johnny. You fat, lazy piece of shit. I knew this arrangement was too good to be true. Let's join forces with the North End, huh? Bury the hatchet? Work mutually against a common enemy? Well, you put the nail in that coffin, huh, boyo? What did you have to do, Johnny? Huh? What was your job? Sit in your car, on the corner. Keep your eyes open. If you see a uniform, you get out. Walk down the street, knock on the door, and let the fellas know there's trouble coming. Easy as pie, right? I could have got a 9-year-old from the projects to do it, but no. In the interest of Irish-Italian relations, I give the job to you. So what happens? Nothing. Nothing happens. You sit on your fat ass dribbling cannoli cream onto your third chin. You watch. You...
Heard we got a pretty big mess to look into now.
Calvin.
Hey there, you got some tools for me today?
Yeah, here you go.
Perfect. Keep an eye out.
Don't try it.
Dr. Penske's been keeping an extra close eye on Austin since he recovered. I think she's gonna drive him crazy.
Need to check the water pumps again. This sounds funny.
God, Ashes is back. Erin is crazy about that cat.
Calvin told me I want out so I can slack off. Maybe he's right. This work is just killing me.
We keep the vault safe.
I heard about what you did for Austin, and yeah. Thanks.
Excuse me.
Look, I'm sorry for being so harsh before. I'm not beyond admitting when I'm wrong.
Stick to the roads, and you got a better chance of surviving.
Everyone wants a piece of what I got.
Cricket.
So many guns and so little time. You just gotta buy them.
Just looking.
Sure, I have all the time in the world. Asshole.
Make a move, and I'll end you, Wastelander.
This better be an emergency.
Sounds better these days. I'm not getting nearly as many complaints.
Travis.
I haven't forgotten what you've done for me.
Oh, hey. How are you?
It must be some kind of score to bring Marty crawling back to Nick for help. The way they parted wasn't pleasant.
Ellie?
Happy hunting. Always a trail to be followed. Guess it's good I never visited Doc Crocker to get that touch-up I'd been thinking about. Thank you.
there. You look like someone who could use a dog. Man's best friend.
Right.
Why are you selling her?
What the?
Should have just.
Hey.
Hey there. You look like someone who could use a dog.
Why are you selling her?
Oh, I don't want to. But I love dogs, and I gotta make a living somehow. So I raise them and sell them. I'm always blue for weeks after I sell one. But then I get myself a new puppy and start all over again.
I'll have to think about it.
Oh, that's fine. I sell dogs.
Whoa!
Hey there.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian. But what's your business here?
Before I answer, will you tell me who you are?
In due time. If you want to remain in our compound, I suggest you answer my question first.
I was hoping to take a look at the evidence terminal in the police station.
You know about the evidence terminal? Now, how would a civilian like you come by information like that? Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Vault 111.
You're a vault dweller? Most people wouldn't admit to such a thing. I appreciate your honesty. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
I want to help, but I don't like the secrecy. Who are you, really?
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. I've been trying to send a distress call to our vessel at Boston International Airport, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need, the deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
Who are the Brotherhood of Steel?
Our order seeks to understand the nature of technology, its power, its meaning to us as humans. And we fight to secure that power from those who would abuse it.
How did mankind abuse technology?
Before the Great War, science and technology became more of a burden than a benefit. The atom bomb, bioengineered plagues, and FEV are clear examples of the horrors that technological advancement had wrought. We're here to make sure that never happens again.
Your cause seems noble.
I'm pleased that you agree. There are very few, outside the Brotherhood, who appreciate the gravity of the situation we're facing as a species. So, what do you say? Will you help us?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
Outstanding. Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin. And feel free to access the evidence terminal. It's in the records room towards the rear of the facility. Let's move out, people.
All right, big guy. Let's go.
Yeah.
Scribe?
You better get a move on. It's not a good idea to keep Paladin Dance waiting.
Hi.
Why are you standing around here like there's nothing to do? Paladin Dance is waiting for you.
Paladin Dance.
You ready to move out?
Why establish an outpost at the police station?
Given the nature of the facility, we felt it would be tactically advantageous to search it for weapons and ammunition. The radio tower on the roof was an unexpected boon, but it obviously has its shortcomings that need to be rectified. It might not be as imposing as the Citadel back in the Capital Wasteland, but it suits our purposes. That's all I'm willing to divulge at this point. Are you ready to proceed with the mission?
Not yet.
Get yourself together. We've got a job to do.
Hey.
Do something for you?
Heads up.
I'll see what I can do.
Move here.
Sure thing.
Look alive.
See what you can do.
Count on it. It's all yours.